All right, how's it going, everybody? Welcome to another week in Hawkeye Pro Wrestling here on TEW 2016. We are in April, week three, and of course, we continue on to our third official week of the Hawkeye Pro Grand Prix 2019. Of course, the last 2 weeks that we had the first official week of both Block A and Block B, and now I can officially, I have official standings for that thus far. Week one, we had Block A matchups, and after four matches, as you see that, after the four matches, everyone having their one match thus far, Prince Devitt, Shane Hollister, Akira Tozawa, and Sami Sabe coming up with victories. Pete Dunne, Chris Jericho, Will Ospreay, and Marty Scurll all coming up with losses. It should at least be noted that, of course, Marty Scurll had a forfeit loss due to his ankle injury. He will be back this week. If I check the medical, he should be back this week officially to come and try to regain the ground that he had lost in the Grand Prix. And, of course, we'll look at Block B after week number one. Of course, Katsuyori Shibata, Samoa Joe, Kurt Angle, and Juice Robinson all coming up with victories and 3 points apiece. Cesaro, Adam Cole, Toru Yano, and Sonata still with their losing match have not gotten on the board yet. So those are the official standings thus far in the Grand Prix. And, of course, we get to move on to week number three. And the second official matchups for Block A. And I kind of realized I don't actually have it up. So hello to you guys in the chat. Appreciate you guys being here. I just got to set everything up here. There we go. All right. Now I've got everything. Now I've got everything in front of me. I always forget. I always tend to forget my deal here with the Grand Prix. I always forget to bring that with me. Let me look at something real quick, because I think I actually managed four. Da, 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 da. There we go. I had to redo some of my stats and stuff like that with some of the changes that I made here, but we got a third week here for this. Let's see, we are on Monday. I always forget something, but I'm not 100%. I don't think I have anything officially right now. So I'm going to go on. Took your idea to do a women's promotion to run in TEW resulted in me hiring the Godfather. I hope he is the GM. He just runs the whole thing. I'm trying to think. You could just name it ROH, Ring of Hoes. Oh shit. Coming out with the broadcasting deals. Oh, they're doing tour highlights. Okay. I think I need to look into that here soon. I'm not quite there, but I'm on my way when it comes to stuff like that. No. Trying to see here. Yeah. I knew he was leaving, but I didn't really care enough to try to sign him. I'm pretty sure that's not even, I wouldn't really need her anyway. Yeah, nothing. All kind of quiet right here. Harmful Rib Republic firing of Lady Beard. I have no idea exactly what I'm going to do about that. You know what? I'm going to see if I can. Takahashi makes about $24,500 a month. I gave him $10,000 and he's still angry. So, yeah. I don't exactly know what to do about that. Because I don't want to give him, like, too much money. That's just ridiculous. That's all right. We'll get to Tuesday. I think there should be contracts coming up super duper soon. I'm pretty sure I put them on my short list. Like, I don't want to reveal my short list because it has, like, a lot of stuff over the next, like, 2-3 months as far as signings are concerned. Hey, Jason Strife. He actually runs a promotion out here in Omaha. Actually, he actually runs the company that was the original name for this when I first started way back when, and that was Magnum Pro, before I just gave it my own flavor. Bronson Matthews was released from NXT around the same time. Yeah, I heard about that. Give bonuses as a whole, not separate increments. Yeah, I thought 5,000 would be cool, but then it wasn't, and then another 5,000 was like, eh. All right, Marty Skrull's officially back. Luke Gallows has officially joined as Tex Ferguson. So do I already have... Did Carl already join? No, 3 days. Okay. But I could still potentially run an angle with Tex Ferguson looking for Too Bad. You seeing Too Bad around here? I'll have to do something with, like, him and Devitt. Devitt just... An angle of him in full Tex Ferguson gear. A full Tex Ferguson get-up. Interacting with Devitt, who has to no-sell it. Should I sign? Oh, my God. That 93 announcing. And 76 color. I should do that just to have Michael Cole have to sit in between, like, Joey Styles and Shawn Michaels at the announcer desk. I wonder how much that would actually cost to steal him away from WWE. I'm trying to see if there's anything else. Nothing, like, jumps out at me. How much are they charging him? $10,200. I don't think I really... I think the way I have it now is I keep shuffling around my announcers as much as I do. Like, I just need to get their experience level up. So if I keep going with just these two guys, I think it'll be fine. I just got to keep it going like this. Yeah. By the way, it's amazing is that Joey Styles is announcing is an 89. Michael Cole's is a 93. Did his actually go down? Was that like... It's actually been wavering between 89 and 90. Michael Cole is rated higher than Joey Styles. A man who frequently would broadcast pay-per-views by himself. Just thought that should be thrown out there. Do they gain popularity? Okay, they don't gain popularity at all when they're... Except for this weird jump where he seemed to have gained like 20 points in... What is that? Why did he all of a sudden gain 20 points in popularity? Was he a part of an angle? I think I put him a part of an angle. I don't know if that really gave him that 20 points extra boost, but sure, whatever. All right, Marty Skrull and Tex Ferguson both need. Let's just do auto push. Let me make sure no one's... That it's all just pure wrestlers. Finley. Let's see here. I guess Brother Ray is technically considered a wrestler, so I'll just kind of leave it as is for right now. Foley, Kyoto, let me see here. Prince Devitt. Okay, cool. This will give me an idea of where everyone sits for that. Look at that. Shibata, Brother Ray, Kurt Angle, Tama Tonga, Mark Briscoe, Alex Reynolds, and Alex Shelley are our main event guys. Why is Mark above Jay? Is Mark, like, just a little more over than Jay? Because that's amazing to think about. Okay, mostly 79, 78. This is an 82, 81. Has he been taking losses or something? What the hell? He's, like, a good 5 points above him. That's weird. Okay. Stop feeding Mark those wins. I guess so. Hey, remember when Matt Hardy said Mark Briscoe wasn't worth a damn? Yeah, I remember. All right. Cesaro needs to be assigned a gimmick. Did I not give him a gimmick? Oh, I must have. You know what? Last time, I think that was when I had to redo everything. What can he do? Where do I have him sit right now? Because I already have him. See, okay, he's a face. Let's see here. Yeah, legitimate face. That seems like the best idea. So, legitimate face. See what he could do here. Oh my god. He also feeds Shelly wins too. Yeah, I do. I know I do that, yeah. I feed Shelly wins, but I also try to feed Kush. I try to go back and forth with that. The tag roster really isn't all that limited either. I just need to start using a lot more of them. I try to do that, except, you know, I usually got, like, at least two tag teams, like, going at it. I just, you know, only so much time is, like, I gotta work on a lot of the singles. I gotta work on a lot of the single stories, and then there's tag stories being thrown in there, too. Oh my god, Cesaro's an armed force. We just give him an arm, like a military gimmick. How about no gimmick needed? That seems like a guy. Yeah, we'll do that. I think he can do it. No gimmick. He doesn't need a gimmick. He's Cesaro. That's his gimmick. All right. Oh, where are we this week? I already lined up where I was going to be. Memorial Hall in Kansas City. I believe that's Mid-South. KS. Ah, damn. Or maybe it's Missouri. Oh, shit. So, Midwest? Wait, where the fuck is it? I feel like I got a lot less than I should right now. Hang on. I know I should have it. Maybe it's like Kansas City Memorial Hall. It's not Atchison. Oh, okay. So it's got to be named something weird. Kansas City Memorial Hall, that's what it was. Perfect. All right. Usually just known as Memorial Hall from what I've seen. Interestingly enough, when it comes to that, I believe, if I remember right, Memorial Hall in Kansas City is where Ric Flair won his first NWA world title. Because I believe it was the one he beat Harley Race for. So I think it's his first. So just a little deal there. Let me see here. So we got the GP matches to put up. So the Hawkeye Pro Grand Prix matches are up here. Let's see. We have got... All right. Take that out. Marty Skrull. Why don't I just kind of do it like this, too? Marty Skrull versus Chris Jericho. There we go. Oh, boy. We'll give it 12 minutes. Lower mid-card. Occasional wrestler. He's probably not going to like this, but... Marty Skrull going over. We're going to open match it. Do they have the psychology? He's got okay psychology. Probably not worth trying to call it in the ring, though. So we'll just leave it as is. Decisive win. Should I make it decisive? Yeah, fuck it. Let's give him something. Oh, man, he is furious. Okay. I guess keep it strong. All right, so here we're going to not make it as clean. It'll be tainted, but you're still... Skrull's still going over Jericho, and there's no ifs, ands, or buts about that. Skrull's going over. It's fine. I think in real life, Jericho wouldn't give a shit, but that's fine. let's see here. We have got Osprey and Tozawa. Let's go Tozawa and Will Osprey. You think this is gonna win when he wins? Okay, Pro Grand Prix. Oh man. See, I know he can go a little ways. I don't know if he needs to wrestle that much. Yeah, let's give it to him. Let's give them a little bit. Let's give them about 18. We'll get it close to 20, but not quite. Oh boy, this is gonna be another one that's gonna piss at least the wrestlers that I'm putting in there off. Slow build, let's do decisive win, flash pinfall. Oh, he's not going to like this. Like to continue, yes. Hey, look. Is Tozawa bigger than Jericho, popularity-wise? Probably not, but... To know that he'll... Oh, my God, yeah. To know that Tozawa's more than willing to put over a guy quickly. It's not like he's gonna, like, just get his ass kicked consistently. We're making it a flash pinfall. Just because he's British does not mean I want Roman Reigns. Hey, he's been getting his ass kicked, you know? It's just... You give him some, like, out-of-nowhere victories... And it's a guy that even if he's lower down on the card, I mean Jesus, he's a lower mid card guy. But if he's lower down on the card, you give him a victory or two, and immediately looks like somebody that could potentially, you know, win on just about any given night. Dunn's mid card, Sammy's mid card. I bet you they both could probably go a little bit. Stamina and psychology is there. All right, let's try it. All right. Okay, Pro. Oh my God. Holy crap. There we go. Grand Prix. Let's go 19. And who's winning? Devitt is winning. Or Devitt. Dunn. So Dunn with the victory here. Let's do storytelling here. Open match it. We'll have him call it in the ring. And decisive win for Pete Dunn over Sammy. And that should go pretty well. I think that'll be borderline main event right there. I think having that right before the main will help. Because, let's see, Dunn is almost there. Dunn is almost to that point where he's about ready to hit upper mid. Sammy is getting there, which is a far cry from where he was. Look at that. He instantly jumped like 10, 11, 13, like 15, 16 points immediately when he joined with us. He's immediately worth more than he was. Okay, so we'll do that, and then we have, the last one, last Grand Prix match. All right, Prince Devitt and Shane Hollister. There we go. Okay, Pro Grand Prix. There we go. How long can we go? Okay, 78 and 74. 81 and 83. Okay, so yeah, I think we might give this one 19 as well. And then we go Devitt over Hollister. We go open match, call it in the ring, slow build, and a decisive win. Oh, man. You don't want to put him over? I mean, Devitt kind of needs to be put over. I can understand Shane's with you know, not wanting to quite do that, seeing as how. All right, so Shane is kept strong. There you go. That's going to limit the match. Part of me wants to do Dunn and Sammy. I might actually move that. It actually would make more sense to have Devitt and Hollister, but I think Dunn and Sammy might do a little bit better for our main event and give us a stronger finish. And then, just for things that happened last week, we're doing a one-on-one match. One half the tag team champions, Alex Shelley. He'll be going one-on-one with a certain Lady Beard. And let's give this like 8 minutes. Shelley's the winner. I think there's definitely domination in this part. He is dominating this match over Lady Beard. This isn't to bury Lady Beard, but it's to put Alex Shelley over. Yeah, we're going to keep it simple. We're going to keep it simple for Lady Beard. Let's script it and decisive win it. There you go. And then we'll put that, oh man, let's put that kind of in the middle to break up the Grand Prix matches. Now that is 90 minutes. That is actually about 70%. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this down to about 16. I'm going to drop this down to about 9. 85. I think 84 is about the most I can put out. Ah, damn, I can't remember. Let me see here. So if I'm running at 60%, the most I can do is 70. And let's do 125 times 0.7. That is 87.5. Okay. So if I go the full 125 minutes, I should be just underneath 70%. All right, and the rest I can build up as other stuff here. So now that I have the GP thing dealt with, now I can start adding in the segments for this. If anything, just All Out Ospreay Tozawa. That might actually be an idea. If we make it, let's go like 13 minutes. We'll take that away. And we'll have them go all out. Yeah, TV title's not on the line. There we go. We'll see how well this works. Now we're down to 82, so we'll be good. I think even if we only did 120, which I never do, I always go the full 125 for the most part. Maybe 124 or 123, but... All right, let's see. Skrull Jericho... Let's do, Marty Skrull. Let's do entertainment. Yeah, I think he'll be fine. And then Chris Jericho. We'll do selling. That puts some success here. I'd say neutral. Let's see. Skrull after the match. Cuts a promo about coming back from his injury to win the GP. Then breaks. Ah. Coming back from his injury. Then breaks Jericho's fingers. Good enough. There we go. I would say there's not much of an... I'll put low injury risk and a minor defeat for Jericho. Especially after all the hemming and hawing and bitching and moaning that he did. I can put Skrull over pretty hard. I think that actually put him over quite a bit. To break the fingers of a guy of Chris Jericho's notoriety. Tozawa and Ospreay. Let me see here. Tozawa should be pretty good, right? Yeah, he's been getting... I've been making him better because I keep giving him, like... I keep feeding, talk segments to him. So it's been helping out. Tozawa is backstage. Talks Devitt and Ballad of the Fallen Angels. He pays no mind to his match tonight against Will. There we go. We'll give that like 4 minutes. Minor success there. Do I want him to do anything against him? Let's see. Kira Tozawa. I don't think I could use it. He's not really, he's not available yet. Okay. Akira is furious and getting rolled up. Let me see here. What do you honestly think they should do with the cruiserweights? Give them more possible exposure. That's about the best I can imagine, maybe. Who knows? Kira is furious at getting rolled up. Will runs. So I'll put Will Ospreay out there for selling, even though he's not really a seller, is he? No. Oh, well. Akira interrupted with Nakamura debut video to basically just hype that up. Like, all right, cool. Kira Tozawa lost. All right, moving on. So I'd say neutral here. A little bit of minor success for Will Ospreay. Now, I can't put Nakamura specifically on here. I would like to, but yeah. You know what? I might just do his selling instead. Because I think that's might be... Because I feel like I want to do shorter. I want to do 3 minutes, but entertainment segments being only 3 minutes is not the greatest. So we might do selling so that I can get away with like a 3 minute segment for that. Shelly is backstage. And is out for blood tonight against Lady Beard for his breaking of Kushida's... Ah. Poof. breaking Kushida's neck. There we go. German on the steel steps, the answer with them. Jesus, let's just kill everybody. Let's just kill everybody everywhere. just pure microphone. Shelly's not really a mic guy, but this seems like the best idea. I guess entertainment. We'll do that. I don't really have Kushida available. He's like done for right now. So yeah, minor success. There we go. So let's do Alex Shelley, Jay Briscoe, Mark Briscoe, and we'll throw Brother Ray out there. As Shelley continues on Lady Beard, Briscoe's with Ray. Demand Shelley vacate his tag title. I don't really have enough room past that. So we'll move on that after that. Unprotected awful waffle onto the steel steps. Oh my god. I guess Lady Beard's also gonna get, you know, booted around, so there you go. I almost want to put medium just to, because it's like, Shelly's laying in some extra potatoes in on here. So I'd say success and then maybe a minor success because they got Brother Ray kind of involved now. And so we'll put it right about there. Perfect. All right. Devitt Hollister. You know what? I might not do anything beforehand. I'll just do it after. Prince Devitt, Shane Hollister. Devitt sends a message to Tozawa. By assaulting Shane, and let me see. Let's see. Tozawa assaulting Shane, and what does he do? Hit Shane with Bloody Sunday on a chair. That's all the room I have. All right. So 5 minutes. I'd say a success, minor defeat. Injury risk is like, I'd say low. You know, it's not going to be completely awful, but, you know. I don't want to do medium. That's just, you know, it's like maybe a few moves. Doesn't take too much. There we go. Let's do Alex Shelley, Brother Ray. Shelley is in the back with Ray. Says he will face the Briscoes for the titles as long as he gets and we'll find a There. There. We'll find a partner. Entertainment, entertainment. Maybe minor success on these. There we go. All right. So, yeah. Shelly will continue to defend the titles. He wants a chance to at least defend the titles with a new partner. All right. Dunn and Sammy. All right. So, yeah, this is where Dunn wins. See, Dunn, I have ideas for Dunn. I'm just not sure. All right. All right, so Pete Dunn, Sami Zayn. Dunn continues to hold on Sami until the refs break it up. Let me think here. I'm trying to think how I want to end this. So he has it against him. Dunn leaves after being forced out. We'll just put it like that. There you go. Minor success, minor defeat. There we go. I guess that would also be like a slight injury risk there. Low. All right, so I have 115 minutes, including some things to also potentially deal with. Oh, you know what I need to do? Because I don't think I've done it yet. And that is... Okay, never mind. I've already done it. Oh, okay. So we haven't dealt with the heavyweight title yet. I'm trying to figure out what I want to deal with that. All right. I've got an idea, actually. Alex Reynolds, Tama Tonga, Kenny, Sonata, Nick Jackson, Hiromu. Tama's backstage. LIJ attacks. Kenny looks to cash in. How about wait? Okay, it wouldn't make sense because you couldn't cash in backstage. Tama heads to ring. LIJ attacks. Kenny looks to cash in. Reynolds chases them off with a weapon. Well, I guess I'm just sat there. All right. And we'll give that like 7 minutes. And I guess it's mostly his overness. That's his selling. I guess even if they're attacking, you still deal with their selling. So we deal with that. Let me see here. I'd say it's a minor success, minor defeat. Minor success here. So, they beat up on the champ. Looking to, where should that be placed? We'll put it like over here. We'll break up the Alex Shelley Ladybeard stuff. And so it'd be like Tama maybe heading to the ring for a little bit of something. LIJ comes in. Kenny looks to potentially cash in. Reynolds comes. Maybe he's got like a chair or a kendo stick or something. Fights them off. Chases them away. There wasn't an official cash in, so we just leave it as is. And then I got maybe one more bit. Oh, right. Tex Ferguson and Prince Devitt. Oh, you know what? I should do this. I should put this. Actually, we may continue this. Okay, I got an idea then. Do I have Gallows and Anderson as heels? Okay, I see face. I mean, this does have face written on it, so those gimmicks couldn't possibly be heel gimmicks. Tex Ferguson, Prince Devitt. I'd say sex appeal, definitely. Yeah, we'll do selling. I feel like his microphone is way underrated on this. Tex Ferguson in the back. Looking for his partner. Runs into Devitt. Devitt attack. Well, hang on. Ooh, sorry. Devitt lays him out in the back. Perfect. And 3 minutes on that. There you go. Just a little three-minute segment. Puts Devitt over a little bit more as we introduce Tex Ferguson officially. Thank you. So yeah, maybe right before the Devitt deal. As he's going out to the... Maybe as Devitt's coming out to the ring in his match against Shane Hollister, Tex Ferguson's going, "Hey, man, you look for Too Bad? I'm looking for Too Bad. You ever seen Too Bad?" And then Devitt, just having none of it, just blasts him. "Too sweet me." "Fuck you." See, that what you did was you did fuck you. What you need is fuck you. And I think we're good. I think we got enough segments. I think we kind of hit on the main things I wanted to hit on. Hit on the tag stuff. Hit on some of the GP stuff. The heavyweight title stuff. The Tozawa stuff. All right. I'll take it. All right, let's start the show. Starting it off hot. Oh, you know what I should have done is I should have done like some of the other tag teams in the pre-show. I should have had some more tag matches because I have... Okay, let me look at my title divisions officially. Okay, so I have Cole and Yano, that's one. Time Splitters is two. Reseda Vice is three. I did something with Tex. I did something with Shelly. American Wolves is four. I'll have Tex and Chad Too Bad, that's five. I have Bomb for Your Buck, that's six. I have the Briscoes, that's seven. So I did a little something with Time Splitters. I did something with Tex and Chad Too Bad. I didn't do anything with Reseda Vice or Cole and Yano or the American Wolves. I did a little bit of stuff with Bomb for Your Buck. I did stuff with the Briscoes. And yeah. That's fine. I'll just make sure I do that better again. Either way. After that, let's see. That Fantastic Heat and Great Wrestling to start off the show. Marty Scurll in his now official first Hawkeye Pro Grand Prix matchup. Of course, he had to lose by forfeit to Sami Zayn, but he gets the strong win against Chris Jericho in just under 9 minutes. Blatantly cheating, but still locks Jericho in the chicken wing arm lock and gets a solid win. Jericho still with no points on the board, and Marty Skrill getting his first three. After the match, Skrill grabs a microphone. You know what I'm probably going to do? So after the match, after the chicken wing arm lock, he takes Chris Jericho's fingers and breaks them. Does the finger break spot with Chris Jericho. Then grabs a promo as Jericho's writhing in pain about coming back from his injury and how he plans on winning the Hawkeye Pro Grand Prix now that he's officially back from his ankle injury. Perfect. Backstage, Akira Tozawa was there. He talks about Prince Devitt and maybe a little bit about Katsuyori Shibata and Ballad of the Fallen Angels. Of course, as it was discussed there, one of the GP matches and perhaps the main event of one of the nights of Ballad of the Fallen Angels will be Akira Tozawa and Prince Devitt. And discusses that. He pays no mind to his match tonight against Will Ospreay. He kind of considers him small time, doesn't really think anything of him. In a superb match, Will Ospreay defeated Akira Tozawa at 6:30. I thought I did a roll-up. I thought it was all sorts of... I thought I did a flash pinfall, but maybe it was somewhere else that I did that. Uh-oh. I know I did one. Was it the Skrull thing? No, because that was blatant cheating and then a chicken wing. I thought I put the flash pinfall here. Uh-oh, where did I put it? Akira Tozawa defeated Will Ospreay after a 6:30 and a little bit of high-profile action between them. High-octane going out. It did pretty well for two guys completely going out there and doing what they can. Short match length, that makes sense. Either way, Will Ospreay gets a out-of-nowhere victory. An upset victory over Akira Tozawa. Gets some points on the board in the Grand Prix. Akira's furious after... I thought I did a roll-up. Now I'm just... I originally did that flash pinfall with Skrull. Oh boy, see, I meant to put the flash pinfall here too. That's probably what happened is I did a flash pin, yeah. I meant to do the flash pinfall here as well. Oh well. Yeah, because that's not nearly as... Because, wow, all the props for Akira Tozawa because, man, I had to put all sorts of shit in front of Jericho and he's still pissed off at me. But Akira Tozawa took a loss clean as a whistle by Will Ospreay. It wasn't even like anything out of the blue. It was straight up losing. But we'll pretend that's what happened. Akira is not happy about how he lost. Will runs away and Akira is still furious in the ring. This little hissy fit's interrupted with a Nakamura debut video showing to the crowd. Once again, showcasing the fact that in just over a week and a half at Ballad of the Fallen Angels, Shinsuke Nakamura will be there to debut officially for Hawkeye Pro Wrestling. Alex Shelley is backstage, of course, without Kushida. After Lady Beard last week had broken Kushida's neck, Kushida will be out for quite a while. And Alex Shelley is out for blood tonight as he gets Lady Beard one-on-one. And it'll be interesting to see what happens with that one. We go to the back. Tama Tonga is about ready to head out. He heads out to the ring, perhaps with a bit of a segment with him and Alex Reynolds to hype up the title match. Instead of Alex Reynolds, L.I.J. comes out between Omega Sonata and Bomb for Your Buck. They attack Tama Tonga. They look to grab a referee, and Kenny Omega looks to cash in his opportunity trophy. However, before that could happen, Alex Reynolds chases them off with a weapon. I would say maybe a kendo stick or something to try to keep them at bay. So they scurry away, and Omega decides that it's just not worth it right now with a pissed off Alex Reynolds attempting to thwart their plans. You know, it is still technically kind of 4-on-1, so maybe not. It kind of makes them look a bit geeky, but It's more Alex Reynolds kind of also looking like a legitimate challenger to Tama Tonga. Either way, I would say maybe the other three guys look to potentially beat him up, and then Omega as the leader decides it's not worth it right now. Maybe grabs a mic and says that. Either way, he doesn't cash in, and Alex Reynolds wants to keep Tama Tonga for himself for Ballad of the Fallen Angels. We move to Alex Shelley versus Ladybeard. Did about as well as it could probably do right now. Underarm snap STO, Jesus. Either way, Alex Shelley with a beatdown of Ladybeard for 8.5 minutes. Did about as well as it probably could for right now. Either way, that was about the best we could probably get out of it. Shelley just wrestling the shit and keeping Ladybeard, carrying Ladybeard to maybe a halfway decent match. Either way, Alex Shelley dominating Ladybeard in this match gets a bit of revenge over that. As Shelley continues in on Ladybeard, continues beating on him. The Briscoes come out. They're not interfering in anything right now. They don't particularly care about Ladybeard, but they come out to the stage. They have Brother Ray in tow. Of course, being the commissioner of at least Adrenaline, they come out and they basically demand that Shelley vacate his tag title, and Brother Ray has no real choice but to maybe agree with him and say that this is something that will probably have to happen, is perhaps Shelley giving up the tag team title. Now, he officially doesn't have a tag team partner, and they've been blowing off the Briscoes. Might have to do something about that. We go to the back. Tex Ferguson has debuted in his big evil gimmick. he's looking for his partner, Chad Too Bad, who of course hasn't debuted yet, but he's looking around all around the back. He runs into Prince Devitt. Tex Ferguson asks him if he's seen Too Bad. Tries to maybe too sweet him, just as a wink and a nod. Devitt, who is in no mood, lays him out in the back and heads out for his match in the Grand Prix. And then we get Prince Devitt versus Shane Hollister. Devitt was really off his game. What is it with Shane Hollister that really... Shane Hollister is really solid, but what is it about facing Shane Hollister that tends to get some of these guys not working as well? I hope that's not a thing that continues. Maybe it's just Devitt. Maybe it was his... maybe it's bad consistency? Inconsistency. And declining physical ability. That's great. 36 years old and he's declining already. Fantastic. Meanwhile, Kurt Angle can still put on better matches than this. Devitt's declining quicker than Chris Jericho. Phenomenal. How long do I have him for? 4 years? Fantastic. So yeah, Devitt is not happy about that, but he ends up getting the win with a coup de grace on Shane Hollister and gets a win, his second win in a row, and gets the points in the GP. Devitt is continuously angry and has decided to send a message to Akira Tozawa as a kind of a dealio with their match at Ballad of the Fallen Angels that's coming up. It's probably the popularity, too. That's probably another thing. But either way, Devitt decides to send a message to Akira Tozawa leading up to Ballad of the Fallen Angels in a week and a half for their GP match. And he does it by assaulting Shane Hollister, continuing an assault on him. Maybe throws him around the ring, starts... knocking him around, doing whatever, and he ends it by bringing out a steel chair, dragging Shane Hollister up, and dropping him head first onto a steel chair with a bloody sundae. And Devitt leaves as Shane Hollister is carted off by EMTs. I didn't officially put that, but that's what I wanted, that Shane Hollister is carted off. Not on his own, doesn't get up and leave on his own. He has to be carried out. Alex Shelley is in the back at Brother Ray's office. Says Alex Shelley cuts a deal with Brother Ray and says that he will indeed face the Briscoes for the title. The deal is that they will face the Briscoes for the title. He just will find a partner so that he doesn't have to immediately vacate the belts. He'll just have to look for a partner in the short term to make sure that he can retain them. So Brother Ray agrees to that, and we can set that up. Well, actually, no, I don't have a partner set up for him, so I guess we'll just leave it be. All right, there we go. We have Pete Dunne versus Sami Zayn in tonight's main event. It's just straight up great wrestling here between Pete Dunne and Sami. 18-40 with a bitter end. Pete Dunne gets the win. And we'll continue on with points here in the Grand Prix with a win over Sami Zayn. Zayn, of course, his first official GP match here, considering the win that he got, was by forfeit. So this is officially his first GP match, and it ends with a loss to Pete Dunne. Sorry, knocked that right. That's not good. There we go. So there we go. After the match, of course, Pete Dunne continues on Sami Zayn, probably locks him in a submission until the refs come here to officially break it up and pull him away. Dunne officially leaves after he's basically forced out of the ring by the referees. And Dunne basically has sent a message of his own, not to anyone specific, but to the rest of the Grand Prix people as well. I think I want to continue not dealing with it just yet. We'll keep going with this. Ladybeard was slightly overused. That's fine. Either way, solid end to the show there. I'm glad I put that over the Hollister Devitt match. All right. Hey, look, we got, what is this, pay rise? Company relationship change involving what? Uh-oh, what does Resistance Pro want? They have declared war on me. Do you really want to do that? Is that something you really want to do? I wonder why Resistance Pro decided to declare war on us. I'm just kind of looking at it like, okay, is that really a smart idea? But I mean, if you wanna do that, that's cool. How far down are you on this list? I'm 14. How about you guys? 43? Perfect. I can only think about one way that this could go. So we're at war officially with them, I guess. So what? Yeah, try to do something. Let's see. We should openly mock them. I think that's probably the best way to do things. Like, like if they're gonna declare war on us, I don't want to like do anything. I don't want to do much, like with that. I'm just gonna openly mock them. We're just gonna openly mock them on the shows. Like, can you believe these assholes tried to do this? I wonder if I could just buy him out. Are you guys making money? I hope you're not. I'm ready to take that. Oh look, fucking Undertaker is the booker for them. They're not in a bad enough financial position. I mean, we can change that. These are the guys they're gonna. These are the guys they're gonna do this with. Ernest the Cat Miller is going to It's gonna do this. Fucking T-Money. Player Dose. Player fucking Oberion. Mike DiBiase. Mickey Knuckles, low key. These are the guys who are gonna. Okay. He's bad. He didn't book him to win. Like, all right. Oh, cool. Toni Storm left, did her thing. Now she's over there. 0.94. Sami Zayn is a natural talker. He's worth giving promo time to. Is he? Probably. Makes sense. Yeah, that's all right. Yeah, they player dose, but they don't have player uno. Like, okay, whatever. It just literally just put them on the pay no mind list. All right. Oh, Jericho has big morale issues. Oh, boy. Here. See, that's... Yeah, I want to give him, like, $5,000 of, like, shut the fuck up. Very happy. There you go. Now he's only annoyed. Now people are unhappy. Oh, man. I might have to try to do, like, a clear the air. See if that does anything. My velvet glove and loyalty are moving farther and farther away. I'm not even able to do motivational speeches anymore. I have an inspired loyalty, nor do I have that velvet glove anymore. That's fine. We got breakout tonight. Take a quick save, and there we go. All right, so I think we'll just continue where we were at with the... let's see. KS. Come on. It's here, right? Yeah, Kansas City Memorial Hall. We'll just book it again. Two straight nights. And I think we're there next week, too. We should do this. Small penalty. There must be at least three unhappy workers. I think I'm at that point, so... Yeah, let's do that. Lady Beard, who's irritated, aired his issues, got a small morale boost. Hiromu Takahashi, who was angry, aired his issues, got a small morale boost. He was annoyed, aired his issues, got a small morale boost. Cool. I mean, our backstage rating is still at a 100, so yeah, that's fine. I got no problem with that. Yeah, they get to clear the air. I mean, they're still not happy. That's fine. I'll deal with that. Oh! I didn't put the official graphics up. Let me see if I can find that real quick. Hang on. I gotta do this in a weird little thing here because I forgot to post it up. I have to find it real quick. There. There we go. So, yes, because we've also been on Breakout, we've been doing the inaugural Women's Tag Team Championship Tournament. We are down officially to four teams, and that is Becky Knox and Ashley Flair of the Revolution. Azumi and Mayu Iwatani of Heyman International. Let's see. Ayako Hamada. And Arisa Nakajima, the Reinas. And Nicole Matthews and Madison Eagles, Shimmer and Shine. Tonight, we will find out the finalists for that tag team tournament. As we will have all four teams competing in the two matches in the semifinals to determine our finalists for the tag title tournament or the tag title final at Ballad of the Fallen Angels. So we can set that up real quick here on like that, and then we have, let's see here, we have the Revolution versus Heyman International. Yeah, that's fine. I mean, I can't really change that now. They're already in the tournament. Uh, Women's Tag Tournament. Let's just put it like that. Okay, so Azumi's clearly the weakest link. 67 stamina, though, so that's... I can deal with that. Which means you could probably put, like, 17 minutes on it. Help try to get a little bit of a boost out of this. We'll put Becky Knox as the winner here. Open match. Slow build, decisive win. And I think we're good. I think that's about the best we do there. And then 2v2. Then we have the Reinas versus Shimmer and Shine. And then women's tag tournament. Perfect. All right. I think they could probably go a little ways. They got the stamina and psychology. She's got the stamina and psychology. Mm-hmm. I think I'll give them like 20 minutes to show themselves off here. Maybe. See, that was an 82 stamina. That was a 90 stamina. Jesus. Let's give it 22. Let's really go in on this. And then we have Nicole Matthews with the win. We'll do the storytelling here. Open match. Call it in the ring, slow build. And let's go with... Let's go with a tainted win. So they win, but they did a little bit of cheating to get there. Either way, they get the win nonetheless. So we'll just have to figure out where we're going to place all that amongst everything else that we have going on. And break out what we got so far. Let's see. We got Dash Chisako, Courtney Rush. So I think I want to do a Kairi. Oh, you know what? Okay. So I think we kept it going last week. We need to do that. Because we did do... I did run an angle about how they wanted a chance at Io Shirai. So, Io Shirai and Kairi Hojo. And, oh boy, how long can we give them? 82 and 84. 77 is 73. And let's put 20. Let's put 20 out there. Io Shirai getting the win. Yeah, let's try the storytelling here as well. Open match, slow build, and decisive win. So Kairi does get her shot at EO. So we'll have that. Let me see here. We could probably do one more short match. What should we have for a short match? Do I have Athena already? Might have to... Not for 2 days. Okay. So she's not officially here. Okay. So... Oh, man. All right. What was I working with last time? All right. So we got Kimberly Martinez. All right. So we haven't really done anything with Sheeta or Martinez. So maybe something with Martinez so that she can go over. All right, let's do that then. Let's do Mercedes Martinez, and she should face a face Who's expendable? I think Jessie McKay. Oh man, she's kind of in a minor negative. You know what? It would actually make some sense with Evie. After the week after kind of like firing them. Well, I mean, they're a tag team. I don't really want to do... you know what? That's fine. I think we'll be fine. 75-85. 76-82. Okay, well, it's not going to be much of anything anyway. It's going to be like 9 minutes. Maybe. I don't know. Let me see. We're at 65 now. We could probably put it up a little bit more. Mercedes getting the win. Let's not do open match. I think that more fits Evie than Mercedes. But we'll... you know what? We'll open match it. Why not? Just in case. Decisive win, though. Because I think she's technically... Let me see. Mid-South 31. And then she is a 34. So, like, it wouldn't even be that big of a difference anyway. Which is fine. There we go. We'll throw that, like, somewhere in here. Io and Kairi. God, should that be a main event? That should be the main event. We could do that. All right. So I got a few things. All right, so we're 78 minutes, and now the rest of the time now gets to be spent booking around what I want to do here. Let me throw my storylines over. One second here as I'm kind of looking. All right, yeah. I kind of already know what I want to do. So we'll keep that as it is. All right. The Revolution versus Heyman International. Becky Knox. Ashley Flair. Brittany Knight. All right. So they're selling, and she's talking. That's probably one of her strong suits. Yeah, let's do that. The Revolution celebrate, and Knight vows. With there and her wins at Ballad of the Fallen Angels. The Revolution will rule. How about that? I guess it would be like rule over breakout, but we'll just... The Revolution reigns. They reign supreme. Bana. All right. yeah, minor success on all of them. They got wins. We're good. And that helps kind of continue the women's deal. Mercedes Martinez and Evie... maybe we should do... We'll do Hikaru Shida. Let's see. Shida is... via satellite. As she worries about her safety... and discusses let's see, finishing business with and you know what, says things were finished with Mercedes. To be fair, she was carted out in an ambulance. Like, they had, like, an ambulance match, and Mercedes Martinez won. So it makes all the sense in the world that when Mercedes Martinez comes back out of nowhere to say that she has unfinished business with her, Sheeta would say, no, you carted me out. This is really not going to help. But actually, you know what? I got an idea then to help boost this. We'll put them. Yeah, this is. We'll put none here. We'll have them talk with her. That'll be how this works. They will carry her through the segment and take a little bit of success with it. We'll build them up. There we go. So there you go. We'll have Styles and Michaels discuss it with her. Mercedes. Evie's carried off. Whoops. Wow. By Kaylee Ray. Mercedes grabs a mic and tells Sheeta she wants her opportunity trophy. So that way you have an idea of exactly what she wants, letting you know that she wants that opportunity trophy. There we go. We'll set that here. And I think, let me see here. Nicole Matthews, Madison Eagles, Portia Perez. Let's see. Perez is happy to see Shimmer and Shine in the semis and wishes them luck tonight. And so we'll give them like 4 minutes to do that. Of course, kind of playing off of Portia Perez's friendship with Nicole Matthews. And then we'll move back here. Mick Foley, Portia Perez. Perez is happy to see Shimmer and Shine win. Shimmer and Shine in the finals, as Foley is unhappy about cheating to get there. There we go. So we'll get that down to like 4 minutes. We'll do, let's see, entertainment. Yes, minor successes, why not? I think that's pretty good then, right about there. Alright, so before we do any of this, let's see. Alright, so I need to make sure I'm set up for this. Alright, so we'll put something out here first. Dash Chisako, Kairi Hojo. Dash and Kairi prepare for Kairi's match against EO. Tells Dash she wants to end what they... Kairi says she wants to end what they started. Perfect. So basically at least mentioning the fact that, you know, both of them kind of set EO off the deep end with the losses against them at both Final Fight and as well as Deadstorm Rising with Dash Chisako. Want to at least mention that, hey, get this up and ready. And I'll put that right about there. And so, yeah, very much ready to take off and finish what they started against Io Shirai several months ago. And all right, let's see if I can put together everything here. Io Shirai, Maya Iwatani, Azumi, Mio Shirai, Paul Heyman. Io is furious at Mayu and... Oh, hang on. At Mayu and Azumi for losing. Berates Mayu. Then slaps Azumi. Which Mio runs into... which Mio stands up to her. Mio stands up to. How about that? And that's about all it is there. So I guess selling. Let's go entertainment and maybe entertainment. I'd say minor success here, maybe a minor success here. So yeah, kind of a bigger angle there. All right, let's see. Io Shirai, Paul Heyman, Mio Shirai. Heyman. Post-match. Let's see. Heyman post-match goes off about EO being... well, hang on. I want to think about what is it that I want to say about this. Heyman post-match. Unhappy EO hasn't gotten her shot at gold yet. Mio walks out to confront about earlier. Let's see. Mio confronts EO. Heyman. Let me see. Mio confronts EO. Heyman. I want the words to say that he kind of lessens the situation, like brings it down. Heyman dampens heat. Heyman calms it. There we go. Good enough. So we'll do like that there. So that should be pretty good as is. By the way, has she been around long enough? Yeah, she's been around long enough to speak fluent English. Okay. There we go. And then we can put that right there at the end. And I think there might still be a couple other things I want to do. Let me see. I still got women that I could use. Allison Kay, Jessica Havoc, Courtney Rush, Leva Bates. Okay, I haven't really done anything with... Okay, so, yeah, Leva Corp. Oh, man, did I not change that out? I thought I changed that out, honestly. Here we go. That needs to be like that. There's only three of them now. All right, those four, the Revolution, Heyman International is, yeah, all five of them. Cool. All right, so then... I want to try to do something with Leva Corp. Let me see what I did with Leva Corp last week, besides have them lose. Oh no, they lost 2 weeks ago. Okay, let me think. Alright. Let's do Leva Bates. Let's do Mia Yim. Let's do Courtney Rush. Leva Corp in the back. Dissension is occurring, but Leva calms it down. Yeah, we'll just do like a little bit here between the three of them. Nothing really big right now. But we'll just kind of leave it as is there. We'll move this like maybe back here. We'll put it like right back here. So then we have 119 minutes. And then maybe we'll do something with Kimberly. How about that? We'll use her mic and charisma skills, maybe with Lufisto and Jesse McKay. Lee is out with Lufisto and McKay. And they mock Leva Corp for the dissension while Lee has found new friend. Da-da-da-da-da. There we go. All right, now she has new friends. Boom. All right, minor successes all around here as they do a little something with that. Maybe put that... maybe, like, right there. And I think that'll be it. I think we're good enough at that point. Got 14 segments. Good enough. I think that's kind of how I want to end it. Yeah. So, weirdly enough, Kana, I'm kind of not putting Kana on the show. Not because I couldn't especially use her, but shine a little bit of light on some of the other people here. While we have we have our finalists for the tournament, so there's no tournament stuff to do after this. So, besides the finals, so we got plenty of time to use her later. All right, Starting off with our opening bout, The Revolution versus Heyman International in a semi-final match here. Opening at breakout. Pretty good. Mayu seemed to have kind of carried a lot of that. Ashley Flair and Becky Knox, all three, did pretty good there. They don't work well as a team. That's fine. I mean, there's not too much I can really do about that, but there you go. The Revolution picking up the win, and Becky Knox and Ashley Flair are in the finals, and Brittany Knight is out with them, and the Revolution celebrate, and Knight congratulates them on their win in the semifinals match, and vows that with their win at Ballad of the Fallen Angels for the tag titles and her win against Kana at Ballad of the Fallen Angels for the women's title, the Revolution will reign supreme over Breakout, and they will hold the titles. All of them. All the titles on Breakout will be the Revolution's. We're in the back. Leva Corp is having some dissension, a lot of unhappiness amongst everybody. And, you know, Mia Yim is not happy. Courtney Rush is not happy. Of course, she lost to Dash last week. They don't really have any real prospects. Leva Bates hasn't really been able to string wins together to challenge for the women's title. They lost their trios three-way at Blackout. Courtney Rush, of course, they're not in the women's tag title tournament anymore. Dropped out in the first round. And so there's a lot of dissension, but Leva Bates is calming it down, getting it sort of together. And just trying to get them to rally together and rebuild from where they're at. Hikaru Shida is live via satellite with Joey Styles and Shawn Michaels. Of course, Styles and Michaels, the commentators, talking to Hikaru Shida. Now, she is live via satellite. She's worrying about her safety because it's bad enough when someone like Io Shirai is running around backstage beating up God knows who, and not much has really been done about it in the last few months. But on top of that, she now officially has someone who is hunting for her, and that is Mercedes Martinez, wanting to take away that opportunity trophy. So she's not the biggest fan of being there. And says that, of course, things were finished with Mercedes back at Final Fight. They had the ambulance match. She lost, but she worked her way back in. She worked her way back into the Women's Opportunity Trophy. Won the Women's Opportunity Trophy. Mercedes Martinez since wasn't able to capture the women's title. So she says that things were finished between her and Mercedes. She doesn't really know. But she has an assumption that Mercedes is, of course, just trying to get the Women's Opportunity Trophy from her. Speaking of, Mercedes Martinez comes out against Evie in just about 11 minutes, gets a quick win over Evie. And decent little match between them, I'd say. Either way, after a Fisherman Buster, Mercedes Martinez beating Evie. And as Evie's kind of carried off by Kaylee Ray, Mercedes grabs a mic and tells Shida she, of course, does want the opportunity trophy, and she is willing to do what it takes, much like she did several months ago against Hikaru Shida. She's willing to do what it takes again to get the opportunity trophy off of her. We go back, and Kimberly is with Lufisto and Jesse Piquet, and of course, Kimberly saw what had happened with the dissension amongst the Leva Corp members, and they're kind of mocking Leva Corp for the dissension. And while Kimberly seems to have been able to attach herself to the resident superhero Lufisto, as well as the superhero in training, her sidekick Jesse McKay, and has found herself potential new friends amongst the women of Breakout, stating, of course, she doesn't need Leva Corp anymore. She has her own thing that she gets to have. Nicole Matthews and Madison Eagles are in the back with Portia Perez. Perez has, of course, been good friends with Nicole Matthews, and I believe as well as Madison Eagles. So Perez is very happy to see Shimmer and Shine in the semis that they had won a couple weeks ago. I think maybe it was just last week, actually, that they won. Wishes them luck tonight. She says, of course, she's the assistant commissioner, but she is rooting for them to continue their winning ways. Dash and Kairi are in the back, and they're preparing for Kairi's match tonight against Io. They were granted a match, and Kairi Hojo is going to be taking on Io Shirai later on tonight. Kairi says that she wants to end what they started, of course, with what happened at Final Fight, followed by Dead Storm Rising. They feel that Dash and Kairi teaming up has sort of created the monster that has become Io Shirai, and they look to end that tonight with Kairi Hojo's match in the main event. We move on to our next semifinal match, and the Reinas take on Shimmer and Shine. And in 21:47, Shimmer and Shine get the win, using the ropes for leverage, a little bit of cheating to make it happen. However, they get the win, and Shimmer and Shine is off to the finals to face the Revolution for the first ever Women's Tag Team Championship. Now, night two, we've already got a couple of matches set up there. Night one is going to be mostly GP matches, but it will feature the Women's Tag Team Championship Tournament Finals. And that will be the Revolution versus Shimmer and Shine. Yeah, that's fine. We won't ignore it, because I'll probably need to remember. Women's Tag Team. So the Women's Tag Team title's on the line. We will determine our first champions on night one of Ballad of the Fallen Angels when the Revolution face Shimmer and Shine. Perfect. And Mick Foley's in the back with Portia Perez. Mick Foley is not happy to see that Shimmer and Shine had to cheat to get there. He feels that there was some definite underhanded tactics that have occurred to get that far. And he's not happy about it, but not a whole lot he can do about it right now. Portia Perez at this point is just elated to see that, of course, two of her best friends are indeed in the finals for the women's tag titles. We're in the back, and all of Heyman International in their locker room here. Of course, Mayu and Izumi lost earlier in the night, and they're knocked out of the women's tag titles. Io Shirai, as sort of the leader of it, is furious with them for losing. She gets in Mayu Iwatani's face, who doesn't really have much anything to say at this point. Just kind of cowers. Gets in the face of Izumi, who's maybe not cowering nearly as much. Izumi's not happy about it, but Io gets in her face and eventually slaps Izumi. And that prompts her own sister Mio Shirai to get up, stand up to her, and sort of confront her about that. She feels that wasn't extremely necessary at all. And they sort of argue a little bit back and forth, but Paul Heyman kind of talks it down for a second, and Io Shirai just storms off. Of course, she has a main event match to worry about, so she doesn't care one iota about this. She needs to get ready for her match, and leaves Io Shirai to care for Izumi as Paul Heyman tries to sort of calm this situation down a little bit. And then we get to the main event of the evening, Io Shirai versus Kairi Hojo. Fantastic heat and great wrestling. In just over 20 minutes, though, after a moonsault press, Io Shirai getting the win over Kairi Hojo. And not able to kind of stop what they've been able to do, kind of stop what they started with, creating this monstrous Io Shirai. And, so Io Shirai continues on with what she's been doing. And Heyman, of course, post-match is unhappy that Io still, after the last couple of months, has not gotten a title shot yet, not had a shot at much of anything at this point, and is hoping to change that and do something about this goldless Io Shirai. Mio Shirai comes out to confront Io about what happened earlier, and they get in each other's faces, kind of argue back and forth about it. Paul Heyman kind of steps in and eventually calms things down and tries to get them back to normal. But there is some serious tension between Io and Mio. And that will end the show. Pretty okay, 81. Oh, wow. This is actually... actually, I think that's about as many regions as I can get. Maybe it's supposed to be 29. So maybe I'm a little too good in Midwest at this point to be stringing together. Now that I've gotten pretty big, at least in the Midwest, it's got to take some pretty good shows to get there. Uh-oh, what happened? Oh, okay. Many fans noticed at the HPW breakout, they took many verbal shots at RevPro. This apparently was intentional within the company's management. A lot of people found the shots quite funny, and generally they seemed to have hit their mark. Uh-huh, they can go fuck themselves. What are they? Yeah, it's like Joey Styles and Shawn Michaels are firing away, basically openly mocking what RevPro decides to declare a war on them. It's just like, yeah, sure, whatever. Cool. Breakout TV rating 0.94. It seems to have gotten just about as many people as Adrenaline did. 709, 708. I mean, we got so close to that 1.0 last week. But hey, at least we're kind of building up a little bit. I don't mind. We're kind of building up upon that. So we're right there. We're past the 700,000 mark. Now we're almost at a 250,000. Before I do anything, I have to look. Because there was a few people I was looking at getting. And I saw it. And I don't know why it wasn't on my short list. So let me go back over here. Because Chris Hero was the guy I was looking at getting. Oh, Cesaro, Porsche, Perez, Finlay. A lot of people think that he's worth it. 7,000, really? Okay, so we're going to do 3 years, and we're going to bump this up to 10. So we're going to try to price him out, or they're really going to have to go through something here. But we'll give you like 7,500 there. All right, whoops. Oh, my God. There we go. Okay, so Chris Hero. There's a few other guys. All right, let me take a look at the short list real quick to make sure that they're on here. They're not on here. Okay, hang on. I want to look at something because there's a couple more guys. I guess I might as well do this. I mean, I'm not actively changing anything. I just want to see because there's a couple of guys I know are very, very close. Whoops. Oh, come on. Okay, so he's got 3 days left, and then he is 1 day left. Okay, so probably by the end of me doing this, they'll be ready to go. So, let's shortlist him, and then shortlist him. There you go. So I'll get the official deal with that. Actually, as well, let me just do it like this. I think he should be about here too. Did I miss it already? I don't know if I missed it. Oh shit, don't leave that. It's like that. Okay, so he's very close too. Cool. So, 2 in-game years later. Oh man. Okay, Chad Too Bad and Athena start ready to work tomorrow. So, 2 in-game years after losing top stars to Hulkamania, I'm now looking to start taking away some of their top guys. So I'm feeling pretty good right now. I am more than happy to start doing that. I'm not even taking a bunch. I'm taking 3, maybe 4 with Alpha Jr. I kind of want to take Alpha Jr. just for the fact that I had him originally and built him up. And I could just make him like a lower tier guy. Not a huge deal. There's the contract offer to him. Hey, look at that. Hey, Cody Hall won a title. Oh, he won the Ignition title. Oh, he beat Trevor Lee for it. Oh, there you go. There was that look into, because I think we talked about that with Keisuke Ishii and Yosuke Santa Maria. But there you go. Hey, I wanted to look in on how they were doing, and Cody Hall is the, wow, 90 prestige. Jesus Christ, look at that prestige, man. So Flamita and Trevor Lee, the tag champs. The women's champ, Katarina Lee. And now Cody Hall's is our heavyweight champ after 12 defenses. Jesus. Okay, that's a thing. All right, so we officially have... Oh, yeah, Miz officially signed with WWE. I forgot that hasn't been a thing. So there you go. Carl Anderson left. Ember Moon left. So we got that. Oh, yeah, we got to deal with both Hennigan and Chris Hero. So, oh, he thinks it's a great idea. I think it's a great idea, too. Let's just bump that up to 15 for 3 years. Not covered, but let's give you 13,000. There you go. And then Hero. I'll just do it like that. All right, so what are they offering him now? A lot of people think it's a good idea. We should do that. 9,100. Oh, boy, you're really going to make me. 10,005. If that's as far up as they're really going to go, we'll just offer him 10,005. That'll probably price him out. He's only worth 7,700, but then again, like when I signed Kana, she was only worth about $2,500 a month. Now she's $15,400. So signing her at what I did was way overpaying. Now it's a steal. All right, so we need to auto-push here. Get these guys where they're supposed to be. Chad Too Bad is an opener, probably along with Tex. Yep. And hey, we can officially have them. Oh, we already do. Okay, I already did that. Tex Too Bad is officially here. Athena. Oh yeah, I gave her the Oppressed Minority gimmick. Leva Corp is about to become the fucking Leva Corporation of Domination. Or maybe I can make it the Revolution of Domination. We are the Haman of Domination. I don't know. Let's see what we got. Oh, first. Sonata wants more money. 500 a month? Okay, yeah. 500 a month, that's fine. Nakamura has officially left. And yeah, it looks like we're going to get Chris Hero. So now let's look at Johnny. Looks like they're willing to go a little bit higher. Let's go 17.5. They went 16.6, so I'll probably have to go 17.5. Make that offer. All right, they have a better offer, so let's go up to 19. How about that? Six, seven, eight, nine. Boop. Let's drop an extra 500. Let's drop an extra 500 just to make sure that he... See, that's like a... I don't need... Oh, you know what it is? It's probably the 4 years. There you go. We'll give him for 4 years. I think he'll be fine. All right. Shinsuke Nakamura needs to sign a gimmick. Oh, my God. Can you imagine if he ends up like a mid-carder? Which might very well happen. Where is Shinsuke located? He is located as a mid-carder. Welcome to WWE. So where does that leave our... Okay, Shibata, Rey, Angle, Tama Tonga, Mark Briscoe, Alex Reynolds, Alex Shelley. Okay. Still, Omega, Takahashi, Yano, Jay Briscoe, Davey, Nick, and Tozawa. How many openers do we have at this point now? Or enhancement talent? We got four openers. La Sombra, Juice, Tex, Chad, and then Dalton and Ladybeard are enhancement talent. All right, so we got a full roster at this point, man. We have 63 active wrestlers. I think like 25 are women. The other almost 40 are men. It doesn't seem like that much. You know, that we, and it'll allow us to consistently have people that we can kind of rotate in and out, give guys some time in case people go down or people need a break. I'm rationalizing this to myself because there's a lot more people I could have taken from Hulkamania that I decided not to, because it's like, do I really need seven new people? Three is fine, maybe four. Let's look at this. Yeah, I don't need Shelton. Let's look at these signings real quick. Okay, so Chris Hero's officially signed. There we go. And I do have ideas. Oh, great. TNA have gotten in the middle of this. They're trying to get Bobby Roode. 16,600. So let's give him 4 years at 20. I mean, I want to price them out very, very quickly. So let's give him 17,500 for a bonus for 4 years at 20,000. That should do it. It's like, what, $250,000 a year for Bobby Roode? Sure. And then Afa Noai Jr., which should be the cheapest of them, honestly. It should cost me probably no more than $6,000. Where do they suggest? $5,500 for 3 years? Gotcha. No bonus. I'm willing to sort of lowball you. Cool. Brock Lesnar will be available to start work in 1 week, just after the pay-per-views. That sucks. I wish I could. I mean, I could, but I'll just work around the fact that, you know, it's a couple extra, a day after a lot of the, like, when I would like to have him. Hey, Daisy, how's it going? But at least I have Shinsuke, so I'm way overpaying for him, but at least I have Shinsuke, and he'll be available for our Japan shows. So, bright side. Doesn't look like anything specific. All right. Oh, good. Now I'm fighting with WWE and TNA. Fantastic. All right. Oh, Dragon Gate's trying to take Shelton now. Let me see this. So he's definitely leaving Global Force. He's the global champion. He's definitely leaving. Both Noah and Dragon Gate want him. That's definitely happening. Holy shit. Noah's giving him $22,000 a month. Christ. He's pretty solid. But yeah, I'll just continue this. Let me see. So they altered their contract to him, 51. All right, so we'll push this up to like... Let's give him like 6,000. No, okay. I want him to... I kind of want him to come back, so we'll do 63. All right, 65. You're pushing your luck here. Are they giving him 4 years? Is that what it is? Okay, 4 years. Let's push him back down to 65. All right, there you go. And now I have to fight with WWE's money. This is fantastic. Can't tell you how much I love this. All right, so 22, 25, and 25. All right, so we're go, what, 28? Let's go 28-5. 4 years, not covered. Let's throw 22-5 in bonus money. It'd be one of the top offers. No, I don't want one of the... Here, how about this? How about I give you 5 years? No one else will... Oh, man, you really want to go to WWE, don't you? God damn it. All right. Oh, man. Okay. Am I going to have to go 30 for this? Am I really going to have to go 30? I'm going to have to go 30. See, I can't leave it up to that because he's gonna sign for WWE if I do that. I can't compete with WWE. Like, he'll seriously consider it, but at the end of the day, WWE is WWE. I have to outprice WWE like I did with Shinsuke if I want Bobby Roode. So I just got to keep throwing on like 1,000 a month until I see, there you go. All right. I think that's where I'll just end it here. Because it's nearly 2 hours and it's almost Wednesday. And I can deal with that afterwards. Either way, I got Chris Hero. So let's see. Did I make something for him already? Yes, I did. And then... Oh, I haven't signed him yet. No, the other three I haven't signed. All right, that's fine. If nothing else, I at least got Hero, so that's pretty cool. So he has a heel, and I need a heel gimmick for him. I kind of already know what I kind of want, but let's see a brute. We don't get to have a lot of brute gimmicks. Let's try that. Let's try a heel brute gimmick. We don't get to do that a lot. Celtic Warrior, Chris Hero, Underground Fighter. That'd be interesting. Like a guy who's like kind of nondescript. Like Chris Hero seems like the type of guy who wouldn't be like, who you wouldn't imagine he'd be like this. He'd be like this dude that could really like elbow your fucking face off. But he's had some work. He's put in some work in the seedier parts of this country to get to where he is. He's been all over the world to some of those seedy areas too, to hone his craft. That's why his elbows are so deadly. So I'll save it there. And I think I will call it good, at least for Hawkeye Pro here. There we go. I kind of, like, I didn't have something come, like, directly up, but, yeah, I said I was going to play Super Mario Odyssey, but I think I might actually skip out on that tonight. Maybe I'll do it tomorrow. I feel really bad about not doing it, but, yeah, I kind of need to get off at this point. I don't think I could probably sit here another hour and a half. Not because I don't want to, but because I can't really. So I'll probably have to duck out a little bit earlier than I'd like to. So apologies to you guys if you wanted to see Mario Odyssey. I'll probably do that the next time because I have a couple cool things I'll have to do over the next day or two. But yeah, I kind of need to I kind of need to duck away from here. So our prestige has kind of remained the same. Our momentum's dropped a little bit. I'm not happy about that, but it's only been a couple of points, so it's not too bad. We're still 14th. Doing pretty well in cult. Everything's up to a 37. That's good. The magic number for me is, I think, a 41. I need 41s up to, like, here. Or at least the ones that are 37s, I need 41s on at least three of them. That's the magic number. And I'd love Japan to continue its upward trajectory of popularity, because I got one more week to kind of up that a little bit. So let's hope I can put on some good shows and fill out the building a little bit more. And I think the way I'm going to do it, the next time I stream, because it is a two-night event, I'll probably stream all 1 week, maybe on the weekend. I'll probably do this again on the weekend, when I have like a full set amount of time I can do this, because I'll have the two TV shows and then I'll have two pay-per-view events for night one and night two. So I'll probably cut that up on the next one. So I have this, and then I'll have the TV shows for the next one, and then the one after that will be the pay-per-views. But I'm sure the way I set it up is I'll probably just do the whole week as one stream and just sit here for 4 hours booking wrestling, which is already insanity. But yeah, I got to kind of head out, but thank you guys for coming out. Appreciate you guys being here and being a part of this. And if you are watching this on YouTube, thank you very much for continuing to watch. And I will see you guys next time.